So in the Communication Development Lab right now, we have a project where we're developing two separate interventions with the goal of helping families to promote their children's language development.
Mommy, there's a dragon on the book.
One of those interventions is called Ears On, and the idea is that we are giving parents the tools they need to help their children wear their hearing devices, so their hearing aids and cochlear implants, as much as possible during the day. Infants and toddlers wear their hearing aids on average about 4.5 hours a day, but it's really 10 hours a day that's associated with success. And so we are working to help parents achieve that goal.
What we know from research,
we go into the homes and we do regular intervention sessions with the family that are individualized based on what the parents have told us are the barriers to their children wearing their hearing devices. This research is really important because we know that children aren't wearing their devices a lot in their first years after being fit. And it's just because infants and toddlers, there are a lot of different kind of challenging behaviors. But we also know that even though it's hard to keep them in, the more they're in, the stronger the child's language outcomes are likely to be.
I'll coach you through doing it a little bit more.
The other intervention is called COACH, so Caregivers Optimizing Achievement of Children with Hearing Loss. And in that one, the idea is to coach parents on how to interact with their children in a way that will best support their children's language learning. Margot goes into the homes and she helps parents to kind of recognize what they're already doing in terms of supporting their child's language development and just ways that they can tweak that to be more responsive or to provide more of the types of input we know will support their children's language development.
But then modeling how you're listening and back and forth to her.
The next stage will eventually be to teach providers in the field how to deliver these interventions. One of the flaws so far with research on intervention in the field is that we've been developing interventions that are being done kind of in a research lab or maybe in a clinical setting, but the law mandates that services for infants and toddlers be provided in the homes. And so we're trying to develop our interventions with a real eye toward making sure they can be eventually delivered to parents in the homes within kind of the general framework of what early intervention services have to be.